What's up? Welcome to it. Welcome to the What More Can I Say podcast. What's the episode? 120 what? 2022. All right. Well, okay. This is going to be an interesting episode. I'm your host, Tone Kapone. I probably won't say much. I probably just going to let Zach and them talk. I know I'm just playing, but it's going to be an interesting pod, needless to say. Shout out, Keke. I fluffy. Fine. I forgot the intro.
Yes.
I forgot the intro. She's the first lady of the pod, the only lady of the pod. She fluffy and fine. Keke, what's up? I'm just playing.
Hey, friends. Say no to drugs. I hope everybody's having a great drug-free summer, spring. You know, that's really all I got. Okay, here we are.
Yeah. And my little bro, Zach Boog, the comedian. What up, Brody?
What up, Tone, man? Shout out to Tone. He always does what Michelle Obama says. When they go low,
we
he
get
goes
high.
High.
We get high.
When they get low, though, Tone gets high. So, want to know why my man so spacey and tight eyed?
Oh, man.
So what happened was, I couldn't sleep last night. I've had a lot on my mind lately. So I basically been taking edibles. I was like, yo, let me just take an edible. Mm-hmm. But I tried like a little dose and it didn't work. And I took a big dose and yeah, it's still lingering on from last night.
Seems to be doing a little bit more than lingering.
It's hitting you.
It's hitting different today. So yeah.
It's definitely lingering. All right, let's go ahead and get to it. First of all, what happened over the weekend, Keke? Did you have anything fun?
Baby, my show was lit. Oh, like what did I do personally?
Okay.
My whole weekend was consumed by Usher and Chris Brown. My entire weekend.
Ooh.
I damn near flew to LA and did the homeless thing in the airport again just so I could figure out what was really going on. Because I was serious, y'all. I was like, if I get a Spirit flight out there for $40 and I get off the plane, I catch me an Uber over to the venue in Vegas and I could figure out what's really going on between Usher and Chris Brown. Because when I saw that headline, y'all, I threw out my whole show plan for the day. Like, my whole show was about this fight. So, yeah, that was my entire weekend.
Mm-hmm. Zach, before we're going to come back to that Chris Brown and Usher thing, because I want to know what you guys think. Zach, what did you do this weekend, bro?
You talking this past weekend we've just had?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Something he probably had no
business. I was having a good time.
All right.
No, this past weekend, I was probably responsible.
Well, Cinco de Mayo, first of all.
Oh, Cinco de Mayo weekend?
Yeah, let me tell you about this, Tone. Cinco de Mayo, we left here at 10 a.m., okay?
Oh, yeah, that's when y'all came back.
About 10
trashed.
10 a.m., I see Zach, and he like, I'm like, it's 10 o'clock
yes,
in the morning,
yes, I was
bro.
Yelling,
yeah, he already done had tequila, 10 a.m. So I said, Zach, where you finna go? Keke, come on, let's go get some tacos. I'm like, I still got to work. So I'm like, Zach, I got to work to about 2 o'clock today. I said, I'll come over there after that because I'm sure you're still going to be there down to the spot. He was like, no, 2 o'clock. Oh, no, I got stuff to do. I got places to be. I'm only going over for about an hour. I said, okay, Zach, I'll see you later. Zach left. I did my work till about 2 o'clock. At 2 o'clock, I said, come on, Ryan, come on over here with me to this taco spot. I bet you Zach's still over here. I get on the block. I couldn't even get to the place. This man is outside the restaurant. Hey, Cinco de Mayo. Not a Mexican in sight, but you see Zach Black ass in front of the restaurant having himself a jolly old time. He talking to strangers. He hosted park. It was crazy. So, yeah, me and Zach went over there. We sat over there for another couple hours.
We started playing. It got lit, bro.
It was crazy.
I started having drinking games with the people who was around.
Yeah.
Just randomly, like, you got a margarita. All right, 10 seconds. So I put like 10 seconds on my timer on my phone. We got a chug. Did that with people. I had a great time. I was eating tacos.
And I wonder how much money did my friend spend? Because when I got there, he was like, you need a picture of margarita. You need a picture of margarita. And I'm like, what is going on? We finna get arrested in here. They was like, no, Zach paid the bill. I said, oh, baby, this is a good old time. So it was great. It was great. Yeah, we
Zach Boog!
Oh, he was wilding. He was wilding, yes.
Yes, I have.
That's
fun.
Tennessee State Alpha Zach right
yes.
there.
Yes.
Zach gonna keep the party going. Yes. So me, on the other hand, over the weekend, I saw people throwing gang signs and putting them on people's heads. I saw all.
What?
Where was you at?
What was you?
I haven't told y'all this story.
No.
I saw an old couple. Things that I only see. This is why I said I think that God like watches me like a sitcom. I'm in the club. I'm chilling. I'm having a Hennessy margarita. Chilling. I see an older couple. They dancing their face off. They having a good time. They, hey, we outside. It's yeah. like they an older couple. Next thing you know, I like take a drink, but I think I see something. I look up. I did see what I saw. He's throwing up gang signs. I just put these two fingers up like it's gang sign.
Okay. At you?
No, at his lady. Right across. Kiki, like, I'd be like, yeah. Now, as soon as I see that go towards her, I look at her. She's loving it. She's like, yeah.
What?
Next thing you know, he start dancing. She throw it back at him. Now, this is where it gets funny right here. This is where, because now I'm locked in.
Right.
Because I look over, another girl sees it to make sure I'm not imagining this. I look, dude, it gets fun. I've never seen this. After she do it to him, he goes back and he puts him on her head like,
head.
He lays him on her head. He lays the symbols on her head like, I'm telling y'all, this is hilarious. This is how I know God do stuff. I like
it. Gotta be he double tap, Latin King.
He double taps it, but on the second tap, leaves it on there. So she dancing
with the gang signs on her head.
Imagine he my two fingers on your forehead.
What is?
I'm kind of like dancing with you, but
oh
I
got my head. Oh my God.
I said, y'all crazy. That's too much gangbanging in here.
Way
but she do
much.
It back to him. Boop, boop, and lays it on his head.
I would have been locked in.
I was hollering at these two. Gang love, man. They was old.
They was old? I'm trying to figure out what gang.
Gotta be in the mid-30s.
No one felt like they were in danger, obviously.
Can you tell us what gang it was or no?
I'm not going to say what gang.
Can I guess?
No, we can't. We're not going to promote gangs on the pod.
Okay.
It's a gang that they use two fingers for.
Sorry, my auntie.
Well, two and a tongue.
Sorry, my auntie. This is definitely my auntie.
Oh, yeah.
And uncle, yeah.
It was hilarious. That was one of the
they
funniest
from the west
things.
Side.
They definitely
290
are.
Crazy, yeah.
They definitely are.
Right. Well, let's go ahead and get to this, man.
That's speaking amazing. You should have took a picture.
I wanted to videotape it. I swear to God, but if the man and the woman are both throwing up gang signs, you don't want to mess with them.
They'll kill you. They'll kill you together.
Together. They're not going to beat my ass together and then go home and have sex off my ass beating. Yeah. Crazy.
Some dude in the club.
See how we whooped his ass? Give me some, girl. y'all not whooping my ass in there having sex about it. Crazy. Let's get to this, man. Speaking of getting your ass whooped, Usher
Ooh.
And Chris Brown. Now, they're saying that Chris Brown's friends jumped Usher. I don't know if that's true. That don't make doesn't seem right. Kiki, you did all the investigative reporting. Talk to us.
Okay, according to Kiki. Now, this is according to me. I am the source. It's crazy because Usher threw Chris Brown a birthday party in Las Vegas. He had his Lovers and Friends Festival. He booked all the people in Hollywood to perform. So he had Chris there. It was Chris's birthday on Cinco de Mayo. He threw him a nice birthday party. Now, everybody was at this party. Omarion, Tiana Taylor, Mario, Bow Wow. Everybody was at the party, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, allegedly, there's some beef with Tiana Taylor and Chris Brown. They mad at each other. Now, they've been longtime friends. Iman told me that out of his mouth, her husband was like, Chris Brown, Omarion, and Tiana, they in like this little group that they just clicked in, right?
Yeah.
So, allegedly, Chris and Tiana are not seeing eye to eye. And Chris was like, why are you at my party? Get out. And Usher was like, because, you know, it's like the host of the party. Like, me and Zach mad at each other. You threw me a birthday party. And I come in, why is he here? And you like, that's Zach. Like, that's your brother. Like, what? I know you're mad at him, but he not leaving.
All right,
and I'm like, oh, he not leaving? I'm leaving. So, that's what Chris Brown did. He went outside to leave. Usher goes outside to go talk some sense to Chris Brown. Somehow, Usher got his ass whipped, allegedly. So he come in with a bloody nose. Everybody, what is going on? Chris Brown them done whipped your ass. And that's crazy because I threw you a birthday party.
Yes.
So, long story short, I flew out there on Spirit. And I was
asking.
and I was not what had happened. But let me tell you this, guys. I respect the fact that they have not addressed it. Mm-hmm. Two brothers get into a fight, and it's not leaving from that point. So if y'all get the fight in here, only the three of us know what's going on for sure.
Yeah.
Now, the people in the hallway can say, it's somebody getting their ass whooped in there. But mm-hmm. they don't have no video. Nobody has addressed it. They still went on and performed
probably
together.
Probably me. You know? Tone's much bigger than me. So
well, yeah.
Probably
yeah,
me
you
up.
Probably would get your ass whooped. But no. It's just like, you know, only I would know you
he's took
like
that L. He's like a
little
cat. Yeah.
Only
Tony probably just like toss me around.
Yeah,
make,
yeah.
make me touch
Ryder, Ryder will help you. Ryder
touch,
might help you. Yeah.
He'll break it up.
Yeah. Yeah. No, actually, Ryder's not going
to help you. I'm old, bro. You see what happened to D.Y.? I might have this young face, but I know my body old.
Oh, I fell out. Oh, my
God. That's a habit. I said it on my Instagram. When you got a young face and an old body, you look at yourself and be like, self.
Yes.
Look at me. I still look the same. I'm the same OG. I'm the same Tony. No, I'm not the same Tony. I'm not. I know on the inside what's going on. And I,
that's so funny.
I'm just visualizing.
Like, you know how many times I look at Big Jam and I be wondering, if you ever seen the video of me going down on the speakers of Big Jam? Are you crazy? When I was young, I used to jump off that stage on those speakers like, boo, yeah, I'll be in it. Now, I gingerly walk down.
You stay where it's safe.
And look, I tell the security guards, come here, man.
Give me
so
your
I
shoulder.
The shoulder.
The hell my shoulder.
Boop. Genuine tried to jump down, and that leg gave out. It gave out so fast.
Oh, Genuine.
Oh,
Genuine.
Oh, my God. Eddie got... Genuine ain't little in the middle no more, so them legs only built for the little
Genuine. You know
Genuine.
What I respect about Genuine, though? He takes an actual stripper on tour with him to perform Pony. So remember when Genuine used to slide across the floor, take his shirt off, do all them body rolls? He don't do it no more. He bring another man out to do that part, and he's just kind of standing there like, yeah, get it. Yeah, I respect that.
Oh, that's
that.
Cold.
That's funny. That means I don't look like this no more.
Yeah. You
that's
like,
all that means.
That's all you.
But ladies, I know you still want to see it. Got my man here.
Yes, shout out Genuine.
It ain't me. It's him.
But he got to stop getting high.
What was that?
Genuine got to stop getting high. Because his last time his face was twitching on TV. Then this time he just fell off the stage. The other time he fit. Like, you got to put whatever you're doing, you got to stop it, my man. That's
I love
it.
The cocaine that makes Genuine so happy.
No.
He used to sit up. You remember the sit up thing he did and dangled his leg?
Yes. Yes.
Who did that?
Genuine.
Oh,
oh, bro, you got to see it. He lifted himself off the stage using his hands and then dangled his legs.
Mm-hmm.
It was so funny.
Yes. Oh, yeah, he definitely was. Oh. What's up? That's crazy.
Yeah.
Zach, what did you think about that whole Chris Brown thing? Kiki's happy nothing came out.
I know she's happy nothing came out, but only thing that I could see is when I read the headline, it just said, beat up Usher. And
that's
I just
crazy.
Can't get that in my head. Okay, so I tried to put myself, I'm usually good at putting myself in other people's shoes. So I tried to put myself in Chris Brown boy's shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Chris mad. Yeah. All right, I'm mad because Chris mad. Then Usher comes out and talk to him. Mm-hmm. Now, at some point, you have to think in your mind, I'm finna find Usher. And at that point, even if Chris was like, man, get him. I can't hit Usher. I'm like, Chris, it's Usher. You just can't hit Usher.
That's what I thought.
Of all people, it's just certain people you can't fight. Mm-hmm. So that's why I don't believe that it was actually a fight. Because it might have been a tussle, might have been some pushing. But who's going to literally ball up their fist and strike Usher? Really?
Yeah.
At his party in Vegas? You got to be a bold mug to do that.
Yeah.
You have to have no respect for your mother, no respect for your elders, no respect for your children. Anybody who
pretty
was
serious.
You are a low-down person. You understand how low or high you got to be to punch Usher?
Yeah, you can't punch.
You're not going to do that in the right mind.
No, you can't.
So this is a cocaine infused situation,
and there I'm sure there was a
had
lot of cocaine
be.
There.
Had to be.
And there's always that one dude in the group who he felt like that was his time to shine to show Chris he the realest one out the group.
I even hit Usher.
I hit Usher for you, Chris, and it's Chris' birthday. You know your guys be trying to do the most for you on your birthday.
Yeah.
So I can see it happening.
That's wild to me. That's wild.
I'd be so mad at one of my
Usher
homies
is
for hitting
50
Usher
something.
Stop saying that.
Usher's not 50.
Yeah.
Look up Usher age.
People
Usher
was calling
50.
Him on my show like, yeah, he hit that old man. I'm like, don't call
Usher
him
Usher is
old.
on the other side. Like, he's not.
He's 44.
Damn, Usher's still young.
Yeah, he young and fine.
You cannot hit Usher.
But you can't hit Usher.
That was the thing. My thing is, I don't believe, because jumped, and in 24 hours, if you got stole on, you're going to be a little lumpy. Mm-hmm. He's still going to be a little lumpy. He got right on there to show y'all on the camera. I'm fine. Now, maybe it was a scuffle outside. I believe so.
I feel like it was some pushing.
Yeah. It was some pushing going on.
I think his nose might have get scratched. You know how people be moving their hands, and you be like, damn, nigga, got my nose bloody. But I don't feel like nobody struck Usher, like punched him.
Yeah.
And Chris, you got to see what, like, that's my thing. If I was Chris, I'd be mad at my boys if my boys did that.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, yo, like, you know, he trying to, you could obviously see the play that Usher, because Usher messes with Chris Brown, and you can see the play. Maybe he going to say, hey, I'm going to produce your Vegas residency. Mm-hmm. I'm going to produce it, because now he see the bread in it. Mm-hmm. Or somehow I feel like Usher, after he leaves, Chris Brown is next. Mm-hmm. And I think that it might have been Usher ushering it in for him, if it makes sense. Because Chris Brown deserves a residency. He definitely got more than enough music that could fill up a residency.
For sure.
Are you kidding me?
No, with residencies, I like to see that on the later part of your career.
This is the later part of Chris' career.
Excuse me?
This is the later part of his career. He just started early.
He got a lot of hits in him. He still, every song he put out, we still running it up on the radio. Mm-hmm. I don't feel like Chris needs to do a residency yet. Later, yes, not yet.
I still think Chris is on the, I think that he's on the latter part of his career. Not that he's fallen off. I don't think he's fallen off in no way, shape, or form. I don't think, if he puts out an album right now, we do care about it.
Yes.
If he gave us less songs. That's the only issue with Chris Brown albums, is it's way too many songs, so we can't get through them. We give us anxiety. We be like 75 songs.
I can't wait for Chris to come out.
We play
60 songs.
We playing Under the Influence right now. That was 2 albums ago. You know why? Because we just got through it.
Yep.
So we just now heard that album that had it. Mm-hmm. So if he gives us less songs, but I think Usher has renewed the residency. Look, residency used to be a thing that you did when you were done.
Exactly.
Or you're on your way out. You know what I'm saying? But I think now Usher has made it where you can still be popping and have a residency. I'm pretty sure he shared with him them numbers.
Yeah.
Like, bro, you gonna make this much a night, and guess what? You ain't even gotta travel.
Right.
You can go to your room, come back, everything comes to you.
Yeah.
You know, you can take a break. When you take your break, travel, do what you want to do.
Kids,
but this is a great, you could do this for a year, bro, and come up this many M's and forget what they talking about. Do your Michael Jackson tribute here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
I would definitely go see it. I just don't know if it's
everybody would go see it. Literally everybody would go see it. The thing of it is, like I said, I agree with what Zach said. Vegas residencies aren't looked at the same way anymore. It used to be like, because you had all those old artists doing it. Nah, it's different. Vegas is different. Vegas is really like that, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. If you're not going out of the country and you still want to party and gamble and have those big, you're going to go there. Everybody go to it.
So. Yeah.
Mm. All right, let's go ahead and get to this. I thought this was one of the pettiest moments of the week. Cardi B... And, season $640 from Tasha K's account. Do you think this Cardi B and Tasha K thing is going too far?
And they ain't going too far.
What?
Tone, it was already, you got to understand, bro. She lost that case.
She did.
So her case is she has to pay Cardi B for defamation of character. You got to understand, those were some harsh things she was saying about
Cardi. It was.
As if it was true. She didn't say allegedly. She was acting like she had an inside source and talked about Cardi B having, herpes or something like that?
Mm-hmm.
Like saying that, she was saying that about her.
Yeah.
You don't get a pass on that. And guess what? Cardi B probably ain't even spending that money. She's probably saving that money and putting it in her kids' trust fund. Thank you, Tasha K.
That's a bet.
You hate to see it. If I was Tasha K, I would have been transferred that money to my mama account or one of y'all accounts. Like, baby, you would have to care. I would be broke for the rest of my life. As long as I owe you, Cardi, you would never be broke because you would never get that money out of me. But she slipped up and Cardi then went after her YouTube check and everything else. I just hate to see it. But it also puts a reminder out there, bloggers, media folks, people, whatever, you have to do some fact searching. Like, first of all, why are you commenting on somebody's vagina? That's one thing. But secondly, and then also, I think the problem was, I think Cardi gave her a chance to retract the statement.
Yes, she
and
did.
She didn't even do that. Like, for me, I will say some wild stuff. If you've made it 100 and some episodes with us, then you know that if you're new here, I'm saved, but I'd be saying crazy stuff. However, if I was in a situation like that and I had the chance to retract it, or I know I've come on the pod, I was like, okay, I was wrong for saying that. Let me take that back this week.
Yeah, well, Bow Wow got at you for calling him broke.
He did. I stand by what I said with Bow Wow, but I did appreciate his feedback. But I do.
Bow Wow's not broke.
I don't think
she didn't
Bow
say
Wow
he
is,
was broke.
I didn't say he was broke. I just said, your money is not the same. See, I'm not even about to let you get me back in trouble with Bow Wow.
Okay, my bad.
We cool, Bow Wow. We straight. You did your big one on the Millennium Tour. You really did.
She did say your money wasn't the same, though.
Watch
Bow Wow
the episode.
Say, y'all better watch talking that money talk.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not getting back into it with Bow Wow.
Come cuss Keke out personally.
I invited him on the podcast. You know I'm here for it. I invited Bow Wow on the podcast. But anyway, if you have the chance to retract a wrong statement, take it back. Like, don't double down on something you probably wrong about. Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a tough one. Yeah. That was a tough one.
I would apologize so quick. As soon as they saw that cease and desist letter, I'd have been like, oh, you know what, y'all? I'm sorry. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right.
I think that's why she really got to pay that money, because she doubled
down.
The court's going to look at that like, well, it was false. I understand you do gossip, but, oh, you came back and made it more true. It made it seem like it was more true. You got to pay that.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. That's a bet. Let's go ahead and let's do this. Let me pull this piece of audio up for you guys. Uh-oh. Keke, you'll appreciate this. Take a listen.
Oh, boy.
She finds me.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? It's been a while since I've actually been in a, you know, quote-unquote girlfriend, boyfriend type relationship. Mm-hmm. You know, but I think a private life is a happy life. You know what I mean? But I believe that she finds me.
People can't F up, but they don't know.
I'm just saying, you know what I mean? And it might be she's.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
They messing up.
Yeah, I'm just saying she's might find me.
Oh, she's.
You know what I mean? Yeah, plurals. You know what I'm saying? She's.
You living a life like that?
No, I'm just saying, like, you know, if I really thought about my lifestyle and being with me, like the pressure of being with me, you know, and it just being one woman, I don't know if that exists.
It might take more than one, huh?
It might, because, you know, I might need her to be a businesswoman on Monday, and then we might get freaky on Tuesday.
So
you know
what I'm saying? So that might be two different people.
I'm just saying. It might be. It might be. You know, I don't come from a traditional, you know, standpoint. You know, I feel like I've definitely tried the traditional way.
Right.
And I don't know if that's for me, you know, just being fair, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm definitely open to love, and I really feel like love is acceptance, you know what I mean? So if there is one woman, then cool, you know what I mean? So if there's two, cool. If there's three, cool. But after three, I'm going to have to, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, you trying to be a king? I mean, you mean, is it? I mean, what's going on?
I am a king. You know what I mean? Well, you know what they say about two women, you know, and a man. They say
you got double problems.
No, you got to be double. You got to be double the man.
You heard that overtime. You got to be double the man.
Child.
Now, Keke, I'm going to wait. We hold up.
Yes.
You hold your response, Keke, because I know you are. Damn, you sat up in your chair. I ain't never seen you at that
good
posture.
Sitting up like a principal.
Damn. See, I'm like, damn, you sit straight up.
I'm like a principal.
Zach, when you hear this, man, you hear the young king, Maybach O, talking about he needs plural girls. I mean, the polyamorous lifestyle might be for him. What do you think about this?
Well, the thing is, man, as I see Keke clench her teeth, you know, when people get on Club Shay Shay with Shannon Sharp and get to drinking that yak, you know, Shannon Sharp is one of those guys that makes you feel like it's your uncle, like you related to him.
Oh, yeah.
Like, everybody, when you see him and hear him talk, you relate as a black person because you're like, I know somebody like him. And they always keep it real. They always keep it raw. And they don't give a damn. And they'll fight you. They'll cry with you. They'll do whatever. You know, everybody got that uncle that is just lay it on the line, right?
Yes.
That's who Shannon Sharp is. And I think Omarion got comfortable. And said, because that, usually way more media polished than that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, like, yeah, it could be one, it could be twos, it could be threes. You know what I'm saying? Oh, but you got to give it to him. Omarion tried the faithful one girl thing. Okay? What happened? His damn bandmates start smashing, and then they start trying to make him look like a bad guy and all types of things. So I understand where Omarion's coming from. I tried it. I tried to do it right. See, I don't get mad at brothers who try to do it right and things go wrong.
Okay.
Because when you try to do stuff right, things go wrong. Guess what you go to? Plan B. And what do they call it? What do they call
healing?
It? No, insane. You're insane or...
I know. To do the same thing. To do
twice and expect a different result.
To do the same thing.
Definitely insanity. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
To do the same thing over and over and expect different results is insanity. Mm-hmm. So I've tried it this way, the traditional way, like y'all said it, but I'm not insane. So I'm going to try it with 1, 2, 3. Like he said, he might want one to do business, one to get freaky, one to do whatever he want to do. He said he's going to stop at 3. Mm. You know what I'm saying? But I just want to know, you know... What Keke think?
Well, I'll start with this. I got 3 wigs to do all 3 things that you need. First of all. Second of all.
Three
wigs. I love how y'all supporting this foolishness.
I didn't even say anything
now
yet.
I could already tell. This sound like something out of your book a couple chapters ago. So, I just feel like it's all good until we put the game on 2 players. It's all good. He can have 1, 2, 3. But then when I have 1, 2, 3, it's a problem. And secondly...
Ask Omarion. He might be cool with
you. Well, actually, he and I already have an arrangement. Okay. I'm not leaving Big Tim, right?
Okay.
I'm not leaving Big Tim. And he understands that.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm the one in Chicago. Whatever he do outside here, I don't care what you do, Omari, Granberry. That's our agreement. Now, secondly... I do want to say this because you could give a man your all. When I tell you I'd be around this studio, this radio station, pushing Omarion records on people, pushing interviews on people, pushing your oils, your body oils. I done bought this damn book. You ain't like when I tell you I'd be around here supporting the hell out Omarion's franchise and everything he got going on. Just for you to get on Shay Shay Club or whatever it's called.
Club Shay Shay.
And embarrass me like this. I am personally offended. Okay? All last night, I was getting mentions in the damn Shade Room comments of our listeners tagging me like, girl, you see what your man said? Omarion. I mean, I just was out here having a listening session for the new album.
You were.
A Cinco de Mayo, I turned it on at the restaurant.
We did a shot, and we said, what's this shot for? He keep talking about fucking Omarion new single.
Yes!
And I said, what? And she pulls out her phone and starts playing the song while we took a shot, I swear.
It's on Cinco de Mayo. So I'm out here pushing these records. I am, out here working hard into the damn A&R. All I put into your career, I really would like some more respect, Omari. So outside of that, I just want to say that, ladies, you could give a man your all. I put my job on the line every week trying to sneak a record in into my show to play, and this is the thanks I get. I'm hurt at the end
of the day. I'm sorry, Keke. Yeah. I know you hurt.
We sorry you hurt.
It's all right. I'll
this,
be okay.
This is real life, though.
Yeah, it is.
This is a real life. Omarion, the thing of it is, it's going to slow down, ladies. No man can keep it up. But I said, if I was a Marianne age, I remember. Honestly, the thought of being with one woman just didn't. It wasn't a thing for me. It just wasn't. And I just wasn't man enough to say it at that point. Because it wasn't they got big words for it now. All they were saying was you was a cheater back then.
What they say now, though.
I could jump behind and be like, well, I'm...
Polyamorous.
I'm polyamorous.
Leaves,
that's not a lifestyle that I subscribe to. And I ain't had none of the big words. That's
for my
why I say,
health,
damn this internet. This internet got these kids smart as hell, G.
I'm dead.
Omarion is in touch with his emotions. I wasn't in touch with my emotions. I didn't have words to say. Like, hey, I can't believe you were her and her. Why you do that to me?
I don't know. I like both
y'all. But
what
is it? Is it the option?
That's what told me. I like both y'all.
And he ain't lying. That's the crazy part. As a Gemini,
that's all he can say.
That's all I had the words to say. I like both y'all.
I'm sorry, and I couldn't decide.
That's crazy.
I wish I had the vocabulary that Omarion has. And that, because Jesus, I mean, it's just a thing. I'm not telling ladies to accept it. I never say don't do it. And like you said, it is, once you put the game on 2 players, we ain't going. And but I still say it, and I'll say it again. I say it all the time. Unless you got, if women, let me change that. If women start acting like dudes and they start having, and then neither one of us come off of our BS and it never works. Somebody's got to to stop the
Why it gotta be the women, though?
Because that's just what y'all do.
What? But says who?
Well, okay, how about this? What? Now, this is gonna sound harsh, but yeah. It's true. It's a fact.
Okay.
If you do not slow us down and make a man, in a sense, look and say, hey, you're gonna miss out.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying beg for a man's attention. I'm never saying, I got a daughter. But you always want, because trust me, we ain't stupid and we think about it.
Mm-hmm.
Make a man feel like, oh, you gonna miss out? That's it. That's what I tell my daughter. Like, hey, I get it. You want to do all of that? You can't do that with me.
Mm-hmm.
Or you gonna miss it. You gonna miss out.
So that's what you tell the women?
No, like, I'm just telling. That's what women should think.
Oh, that's what women should think.
Women should think, like, hey, you should make a man feel like he gonna miss out. I'm not saying that you going to... Now, do you agree with what I'm saying? I'm saying because if you on your BS and I'm on my BS, when do we come out? When do each one...
So I got to be the bigger person, the responsible person, the loving person.
Want to know why?
Why?
Because your clock is ticking. Mine never stops.
Ain't that bad of it?
That's a fact.
Ain't that... Right, do you hear this toxic mess? Toxic Tony. Now, we
did I tell a lie?
Am I on
the clock?
Hi, Tony done left the building. Now, insert Toxic Tony. I ain't seen him in a while, but I'm happy he's here.
Because
I'm ready
back.
For your ass after what Omarion just put me through. Okay. Now, I like how you tried to make that sound so eloquently. Like, you know, you have to respect yourself. Mm-hmm. And you control and tell a man what he gonna miss out on. No, I want to taste 32 flavors like you want to taste all 32 flavors. I want to have options like you got.
Okay.
I like both of y'all. Like that. Like why can't
the
say that?
The clock is running.
I don't give
sis.
A damn about no clock. I don't care about no damn clock. I can go buy me some kids if I really want to. Some.
Yeah,
it's a little. Nah. They make them.
You know the difference. It's a difference.
They can print them off the computer.
Guess
at this
what?
Point.
At the end of your after you tried, there's a difference. After your 32 right. flavors, after you tried all 32 flavors from Baskin Robbins, your shit gonna look like roast beef.
Okay, and I don't your shit. What your shit look like?
It's still gonna be smooth muscle. It's an out of muscle.
It's
just gonna be strong.
Too.
Guess what? When you build muscle, when you work a muscle, you build it.
It's so funny because I'm not this girl at all.
I know,
but I have to stand up for the whole.
Have you ever seen
all.
The side of a pit bull mouth?
Yes, that's how it looks.
Mm-hmm, that's what it's gonna look like.
I don't know nothing about it, but I have to stand up for the women because it's so crazy that y'all put this out there. Yeah, I did. Because, yeah, but it's just crazy that y'all put this narrative out. Like, we got to be the ones.
Y'all on the clock, sis. It ain't my fault. God, you got to argue that one with God.
No, I can't.
And y'all are the one that.
I didn't make that up.
And y'all the one that really decided the exclusivity.
How do we decide?
Y'all
right?
desire the exclusivity
yeah, we
more
desire.
Than men do.
No. Y'all desire it because the moment your girl got another guy,
that's
y'all
true.
Out the door.
That's true.
The moment y'all true. We so you know y'all desire us to be exclusive, while
yeah.
y'all could be hoes, and it's
now,
okay.
Up until it's over. Up until we get out of that stage.
Okay.
You gotta find. You really honestly, ladies, you do gotta find a man out of his I need multiple women stage because it does slow down.
I think the best thing you could do is find a man after he lose the good one.
That's the best. That's a good time, too. That's a good time,
too. I look at some of my past people, and I'm just like, you're welcome. You're welcome, sis. Because I'm the one that got away, and now he's great. Now, because he done been hurt.
Yeah.
He done realize
what
the hell that can happen when you play with God's blessings in your life.
So that's what we're trying to say. That's what he didn't say correctly, is men have to go through. What he said was, he was saying, oh, you got to feel like you're going to. Miss something, but what he's saying is hurt, like
yeah.
you're saying.
You
y'all saying the same
hurt.
Thing. A man is better once he's been hurt
exactly.
because his innate, if you just go by his innate, what he wants to do, his nature,
yeah.
he just want to go everywhere.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying?
Yes,
until you get hurt, then you think about it more
yeah.
like, oh, I really that was just fun,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm saying? I really don't really want all these women, so let me go ahead and lock in.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to lose this, you know, like you got to make you feel like you're gonna lose.
But y'all just dumb,
you, but
that
no, but you should thank the hoes that we run into after you, though. Because we run into it, we like, damn. You're like, baby, we're going to eat? What? We're going to go get something to eat? I don't cook? You
yeah.
be like...
And y'all take it. Y'all accept it.
No, we just like... In the inside, we like, ah.
Damn, I miss Margaret.
Hey, look. And this is... remember, I never forget. As simple as thing, like, I really like going to the movies. Like, that's one of my... hobbies. It's like a hobby. I like going
yeah.
to see the. I just like the experience of a new movie because
yeah.
it just still give me that feeling
mm-hmm.
when I was a kid. And I remember I was dating somebody. We used to always go. She had the same love for movies. We used to go see everything. We same love. Then we broke up because of my stupidness.
Yep.
And I remember I was like, you know, whatever. I'm like, yeah, you want to go see this movie? Nah, that's stupid. I don't really go to the movies.
Yeah.
Like, you don't go. She's like, yeah, who? I fall asleep in the movies. It'd be boring in there.
That's dumb.
And all you look at it, and something as little as the movies, you like, damn.
You feel that void, that pain.
You can't feel that void. Mm-hmm. Only thing that make you forget is that you think it's because it's new vagina, so you have fun with that.
I'll tell you what makes you feel better.
What?
Mo vagina.
Yeah, I mean,
that
you
heals.
Could,
heals all things.
You can hit, you can go and screw everybody you want, but you will never forget the one that got away.
You won't.
You won't. You will chase her for the rest of her life. You and you will desire her. You may not physically or verbally out loud chase her, but you will think about her. She will haunt you for the rest of your life. But that's but ladies, what I've learned
both
from my,
ways,
that,
though.
Thank you. That's where I was going.
Well,
go
I haven't experienced
it.
That. But my thing is, I feel like I get men too soon. You gotta get them after they've been hurt and abused, and then they great for you. So ladies, you gotta look for the
we
one
like rescue dogs.
Yes,
get us from the shelter.
Yes,
don't go get no new puppies.
Don't
go
breed
to the
them.
Shelter.
Yes, sis. Yeah, don't breed them, sis. You gotta go get them at the animal shelter. Yes, go get you one of them paws dogs. That's how you gotta do it, because I'm telling you, the ones we breed, I'm a breeder. I breed you. I build you up. And you know what I'm saying? I show you what life could be. And you treat me like crap and act crazy. And then, you know what I'm saying? And then somebody else gonna pick you up from the animal shelter where I left you. And now you know how to behave.
Mm. Wow.
Shout out to all the breeders out there. I've
Damn.
Learned my lesson, though.
I like
only
that.
Going to the shelter
she
from
came
here
with
now.
A little bit of bar.
She did.
She came with a bar. She didn't like that I said that she was on the clock. No woman likes to hear that.
No,
they hate that. And you knew you was going to piss them off with
yeah.
that.
I
you had the argument until you said,
on
you're
the
on the clock.
You're on the clock,
on
sis.
The clock.
You got to make some decisions now.
Please.
You got to hope your money right to freeze the eggs.
Baby, you 38.
38.
So 39.
38. Coming out your hot season.
Come on, baby. Talk about, I'm going to go tit for tat. 32 flavors. Guess what?
I hope they cancel y'all.
If I'm 38.
Get them.
If I'm 38, you 38. I got time.
Get them. No,
what's
you
the name?
Don't.
Just had a baby. He's 79.
Yeah. Robert De Niro. Yeah.
Just had a one. 79.
Come on, man.
Fresh baby.
Yeah. I know women.
Hold the clock, sis.
No, you're not. You go print you a baby off eBay. Okay?
Look at yourself. Look at yourself.
Look at yourself.
Look at yourself and be like,
don't
hey.
Don't let them push this narrative.
When I make this thing bounce around, I still get the same intention. You want to know? You really want to know how popping you are? Go take your ass to the club and start twerking. And don't nobody look? Ooh.
Ladies, do not decrease yourself to going to nobody's club and twerking. You're popping.
Okay, well then don't.
You just got to go to the right animal shelter and get you one of them dogs off the shelf.
Go to the club where it ain't that packed. Yeah. Listen to conversations. If they say, man, there ain't no hoes in here.
You know, go get
you ain't nothing.
You know where to get them? Go get you a man with a podcast. Once a man start a podcast, he done been hurt before. Go get him. Them the ones.
Look, like I said, I'm just saying, ladies. I mean, if it's for fellas, too. Like, hey, like you know, I can get all the chicks. I can, hey, look, if you in your 40s and you feel like you can still move around like you used to, don't go to the lounge. Go to the real club. Go to the NBA where the young chicks is at, everybody at. And if don't nobody holler at you, fam, even if you got a table, nobody want to sit with you, it's time to get out the game.
No, lady.
You
go
got,
get,
you
go
got four
you.
Bottles.
No.
No. You got to leave, brother. It's you. It's you. They got the sparklers and everything. You'll be like, you want to come on over? She's like, nah, I'm good. Me and my friends good.
So y'all on the clock too.
If you,
thank you.
If you got,
nah, we look great.
If you got bottles and no chicks, it's over, dog.
It's over.
I don't know how we got here. I don't know how we got here.
I mean,
to
but
this
you
point.
Got sparklers. You got bottles. You ready. It only dudes coming over.
Hey, bro.
Hey, bro, you mind if I get a little sip? It'll be your boy and he bring a girl. But it ain't your chick.
So that's when y'all know y'all clock is over. That's what you're saying?
No, that's when you know it's getting rough for you.
Yeah, you gotta know if you're hot.
So ladies
you
gotta go out to them guys.
You always gotta test your value out here in the
I'm
market.
Just
you gotta see what your single value is. And if nobody even looks your way in the club, it's time to get the hell out.
Okay.
It's time to get out.
Well, hey.
Kiki, you ain't never had that happen to you before.
No, not yet.
Exactly.
I mean, I don't really frequent clubs, y'all know that, but when I'm there, I'm not worried about nobody looking at me.
I know that's right.
I'm me.
Oh, so they gonna look at that. But okay, yeah, okay, not, I get
I'm
you.
Not. I mean, I don't know, dudes. I'm not even gonna get into.
But
that,
I'm just saying, dudes approach
ahead.
You.
No, because then we're really gonna be arguing.
What? No, we not. Go ahead.
No. It's just, I don't know. I look for my men in certain places. The club is not one.
Where you
so
look
if
your
you
man?
Ever thought I was ever, like, if you ever thought to get Keke attention, invite her to the club, that ain't it.
Okay. Well,
I like men that's on a lunch break in the construction zone. I like men that's down in the parking garage. You know what I'm saying? That's sitting down in the back of their truck eating a sandwich. Or some, even, but the, you know what? I can't, I tell you this.
How do you talk to them?
I don't talk to nobody, first of all, because I'm in a very happy relationship.
But
when I wasn't with Big Tim, I would look at stuff like, oh, he got on a yellow, one of them construction vests. That's a potential. You know, I like men that's on a work break or, you know, down to the, like, I don't want no man that's in line at the club. That is the biggest turnoff to me. Like, what is you going in here for? Like, what is you even interested in?
What if you don't have to do lines like me? I don't
You
do
don't
lines.
Have to work. I need somebody that's work. You're different because to me, club is your job.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh, look at him. He's at work. You know, okay. So he's here for a reason, for a check. That's okay. That's an exception. Like I told y'all, even dudes with like podcasts, like once a man got a podcast and he's not in radio, I think that is the biggest turnoff. Because what is you talking about? Like, I don't
he
want
can't
my
have
man.
An opinion?
No. And then he damn sure shouldn't have time to do no podcast. You know what I'm saying? Like,
damn.
I just can't.
That's so funny.
But I'm toxic like that. That's me. I've been hurt. I'm toxic like
that. You're toxic as hell.
So I just, but I don't look for men in clubs and stuff like that. I look for men at work, on a work break.
That's the craziest thing, though, right?
So
like,
yes,
okay, you and Big Tim, y'all been knowing each other for a while, and Tim just had you in the scope. He's like, I'm going to get you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to get you. Shout out to Big Tim. Way to
persistence
go get you. Go get your
good
prize,
job.
Bro. Get your prize. He waited you out.
He waited you out. You got to play the long game.
He picked me up from the animal shelter. He let me get hurt.
Let you get hurt.
Yeah. He was like, oh, you thought it was sweet over there.
Yeah, but guess what?
Okay.
I've been here for you,
baby. Yeah, my expectations is down here. You know what I'm saying? It's way different.
You all in the dumps?
Yeah.
Come on, baby.
Right,
he washed you off, washed your back.
Got you right.
Got you a new coat.
Yes.
So this is the thing. But you can't, like...
Got your balls,
like,
no, got your nips.
Like, okay, it's a difference, right?
Yes.
I'm coming up, young man, we can talk to women out. You see them in the store, in the mall. You, like, say something. Hey, excuse me, talk to her. People's interactions are so, it doesn't happen anymore. So if you say, if I said something to a woman in a space that is not, I guess, what they would think we're supposed to be getting talked to, i.e. the gym, the club, the grocery store, the store, retail shop, you looked at it as a weirdo. Like, what you doing? What you walking up on me for?
I hate that y'all feel this way.
A lot
because
of
Because I feel like a lot of women, we will prefer that. I prefer when a guy, like I was in a grocery store yesterday. He was 60, but he was like really trying to holler at me. And like...
I'm about to go. All right, y'all.
Did he ask a baby boy? I definitely. Because if I was 60, I'm doing that.
But,
what's up, baby? All right,
y'all.
No, look, this guy knew I couldn't even play with it. He worked there. But I was like, sir, that ain't good. I love that you got a job, and I love that you're still out here doing your thing. But you work here, that ain't gonna work for me. But anyway, so he was trying to holler, and we were in the grocery store, and I made it my point not to act like a weirdo, because most women be like, no, don't talk to me. He was talking and flirting, and I was like, thank you, sir. Yeah, like, I was real cool with him, whatever. So it's just like, I wish women, we have to be held accountable, because we make a lot of men, a lot of y'all are weirdos. That's the problem.
It's men's job. I'm not gonna get that. I'm not gonna make
a lot
women.
Of y'all are weirdos.
I get that. We are. And that's what I'm saying. And that's why we need to take ourselves accountable. You gotta tell men to be accountable.
Yeah.
Women, it's not women's job. It's your job as a man when you approach a woman to make her feel comfortable enough to
But
holler
some
at
women
you.
You hold the dough for them. No, for real.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
Some women you hold the dough.
Yes, you do.
I can hold the dough myself.
I got it.
Now those are rude situations. I'm not talking about those situations.
You cannot in 2023.
Yes, you can. If you're in the grocery store, if you're in a gym and a woman is doing squats and you walk up on her like, hey girl, can I get your number, girl? That's weird.
Yeah, that's weird.
That's what I'm talking. And she had, and if she's went through that 10 times, by the time the 11th nigga come that really wasn't trying to do that, he gonna get the same energy that you did.
But
men
not the
have
squats
to,
I'm talking, have you, and you know you've seen this at the gym, you know you have, and I've watched, and I literally watch it and love it. is because it's funny to watch. I'm like, you don't even know, bro. This ain't the place. Girls on the Stairmaster. Girls on the treadmill. Damn, that's edible.
But here's the thing.
Girls on the treadmill. And the guy stands in front of the treadmill and just says, hey, how you doing? And kind of just to kind of like just speak to her. And she be like, huh? What?
She can't hear.
She's like, okay, hey.
She's
like,
she's literally on the treadmill. That's not a good time. Bro, you have to, that's not her job.
That's true.
Here's what I'm trying to get
that's
you to understand. Exact. You have to have awareness to see what's going on.
Yeah.
But like, this might not be a good idea. And how about the thing you need to do, fellas, I always give y'all game on try how to talk to women on this pod.
I would love to hear this.
Yeah.
What you need to do is say something that has nothing to do with being with her, nothing with trying to get a number. Be quick and funny.
Zach, you're a comedian.
Get out.
You have an unfair right, advantage.
I would walk up and be like, oh, you lift more than me. And I'm going to walk away. She might laugh, ha, 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 boom, I don't want nothing from you, blah, 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 have a good day.
But some women may take that as an insult.
So, all I'm saying is every situation you can find a way to make it not
get
work.
Offended.
But what I'm trying to say is find a way, especially in these hard to talk to a woman places, find a way to be cordial. A lot of guys don't know how to talk to a woman and walk away without getting anything, without trying to get a number, without every.
But why you can't flirt? Well, if that's
can,
what I'm saying.
You, it's like a way you, to do it, bro.
If I see Keke out, right? I see her out. I see her in the mall. I think she's attractive. I was like, yo, I'm in the mall. Let's say I'm in the mall. I'm in Orland. The chances of me going back out to Orland and maybe run into her wherever she's from, she might be. So this moment right there, I see an attractive woman, and I want to just let off a flirt. Like, you look really good today. And let off one. And
let me
one
tell you something.
Off.
I have to put stuff in sports analogies for Tone to get it. just because you have an open shot, means you need to shoot it. Always remember that.
This is a mall situation, my guy.
Okay, you know mall situations are, without her saying something to you first, are low percentage shots. They're low percentage.
But look, this
you
is
know
thing.
That's a low. So you're shooting a deep three, regardless. So you can't be mad at the woman because you missed the deep three.
No,
you shot.
So
you knew
what
that.
You just said exactly explains my point. Is that that used to not be a low percentage shot. It was a 50-50 shot, which most shots should be. They 50-50. But now, because of people's, they don't. Look, I just went to a damn restaurant where nobody would talk to me. I had to order stuff off a QR code. I couldn't even talk to
that's
a bartender.
Why really mad.
Bartender's eyes. That's a social job. How you going to be a bartender and not talk to nobody? You just reading off a QR code. That's a whole nother story. That business model shouldn't work in anywhere else but Atlanta. I don't know. But this is the thing. No,
he's so mad.
No. So now, because things have become so like distance,
mm-hmm.
Now that becomes a low percentage shot. When I see Keke in a grocery store, I'm like, ugh, she might think I'm weird. Or women are on guard because there is so many weirdos out there that follow women, try to sex chat, all type of wild stuff. Mm-hmm. So it's just a lot of things.
Tone,
that
the
only safe place, really, where I've ever seen women 100% comfortable, not to say 100%, but more likely to not be comfortable, is in social settings.
Yes.
The club, the bar, maybe a birthday party. That's
so
it.
So I understand what you're saying.
Boat.
But one thing you got to understand is
festival.
Sometimes you are
big jam.
I guess what I'm trying to tell you, Tone, is you have to adapt to the new game. I agree with you. A lot of this new way that we communicate has made 50-50 shots tougher. You understand what I'm saying? But it's just like it's in sports. When the rules change to the game, you adjust your game. You don't complain at the game. You don't be like, oh, I hate the NBA now. No, you just play different. You play to the new rules. So learn to play to the new rules. If you're talking to a woman with beats on at the gym, sweating, that on the Stairmaster, I don't care how fine she is or how available she looks, that might not be a good time to take your shot. You know what I'm saying? Wait till you see her again. And that's what, oop, caught her. Guess what? You go to that gym all the time. Oop, guess what? Oop, we walk into the car. Oop, here's my opportunity. Now I can say something smooth. Boom, boom, boom.
Yeah. Walking to the car is dangerous. You might get maced.
Yeah.
Man, anything can be dangerous, but I'm just saying she's seen you before. She may be more comfortable with you. You might have said that little few little words, and then they say something back later. You know what I'm saying?
I get it. Sometimes you played a long game.
When I played a long game, and sometimes if you catch them at the wrong time and they know that you was like, and you didn't try them or nothing and didn't say nothing, they'll say something to you the next time they see you.
Yes, because now you broke the ice.
Because you broke the ice.
But that's true.
Your job is to create. All I was saying from the beginning is, as a man, it's your job to create an environment to make her feel safe.
Yes.
I do not feel like it's her job to just accept whatever the hell comes, because that's all they doing all day is accepting. If I'm just supposed to be accepting all day, no.
Yes.
That's too much. That's too much pressure.
I'm an exact. It's him.
I don't play that game.
Yes.
Like, I'm not going to play that game. You have to.
I don't play. I only take shots that I can make. If you want to, if anybody else want to take a tough shot, here you go, Mike. I'm going to wait till you pass with this boy, and I'm wide open, and I know I'm going to make it.
How many times have you seen people just airball? And you be like, ah.
I ain't airballing. That's just terrible.
I go where I want it.
I know how to pick up. When I catch it, I'm going to go. That was my thing.
I ain't never been turned down.
No, I ain't going to say I've never been turned down, because I have. But I've never been what he knows what I'm talking about. The cold shooter.
I'm not, because I've
never been the person to say, hey, it's a group of girls. I like her. And we all got friends. And you watch, and every dude watch, because it's only they're very rare, like, shooters like that. It's a very rare thing. So all the other dudes are looking at this guy like,
to see what's going to happen.
Like, what the? He did it again.
Yeah.
He just do it anytime.
He walk up on anybody.
He's wild.
He got the group of girls laughing. He got it. That's a different type of skill set to holler at women.
Yeah. I know.
And trust me, it's honored by most dudes. The cold shooter, everybody looks at like,
how did you do that?
I just want women though to stop. Because I feel like we do this thing where, like, we be like, girl, he tried to talk to me, but girl, like, it's so, if you are a single woman and you are trying to date, be open to friendly conversation.
Come on, Keith.
A lot of times we just turn y'all down. We really don't want to turn y'all down, but we awkward and we didn't know how to engage in the conversation or accept the shot. So we just shut it down right away. I see women do that all the time. And I'm like, so you're single, you don't have nobody. He tried to talk to you, and you just shit on him for just because? Like, what was the reason? What was the fun in that? And it makes men now only want to get on dating apps or, you know, only they got to get drunk before they'll talk to you, and then by the time that happens, they're saying real wild stuff. So it just make it hard to date when really, if you're single, he's single, you interested, he interested. Stop playing this game of like, girl, like, you know what I'm saying? Because it just makes it hard, but that's it.
Yeah. I agree.
Yeah, all right, that was enough relationship conversation. That was fun.
We podding today.
We podding, boy.
I done got feminist Zach, high tone, sober tone,
toxic tone.
It's been a great pod.
I definitely talked this edible off.
I think he talked it up out of him.
Yeah.
I definitely did.
Got that demon
I was
up off you.
At the beginning. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. I'm not going to lie. Mm-hmm. I was looking down at y'all. Y'all side note, they were trying to have conversations with me.
Ryder got the stiff neck. And anytime Ryder got the stiff neck going back and forth, that means we are running out of time.
All right. So with that being said, let's go ahead and go. Final thoughts, Kiki. Make it fast.
Final thoughts. Shout out to the pod fam. We love y'all. We got some exciting things coming up in the future. So if you are not like locked in with the pod, this is the time. Get in before we really pew, and then you looking crazy. So go ahead. Get on it now. Okay. This is the warning. Because when we pew, it's going to be different. We're going to remember the ones that was there when we was here.
We will.
Yeah. There it is. I swear. Zach Boog, man, final thoughts.
Final thoughts real quick. Tony said that he is going to have us some T-shirts for the summer that he is going to get us designed. He said he actually had sent off a design, or did you?
I did.
Yeah, he did. I did. Watch. It's so funny.
Right.
So I'm excited for the new pod shirts that we're going to get soon within the summer sometime. Before next year.
Gotcha. And I just want to say this. We haven't done this in a while. Maybe we haven't done a prayer in a while. I want to pray for Zach and his hating ways. That's what I want to pay.
Oh, wow.
No, hate on my merch. That's it. Ooh. That's all I wanted to say. Get that one off. And Kiki, I want to pray for her to get out her instigating ways. Thank you.
See, I ain't even say nothing this time. Y'all pray for my heartbreak that I'm over here going through because this man did betray me.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Yeah.
Just pushing that single.
Final thoughts, y'all. Share the pod, man. I appreciate y'all. We appreciate y'all. With that being said, what more can we say?